Testes. 1, 2, 3. Testes. Play with me. Hello, everybody. Welcome to CigarReviewTV. I am your host, Damon Pettit, and today we're going to give the cigar a try again. It is the from the holy crap, all of a sudden I can't remember here. What is it? The something tobacco factory. And I will think about it. Holy crap, I can't remember all of a sudden. Let me see here. It is the it's the carbon, and it is I tried to do this review last week. I did this review, and unfortunately, the review did not take. So now, we're going to do it again. And, holy crap. Oh, the Foundry. Foundry Tobacco Company. And this cigar, they have a few different ones, this one being the carbon. They are all based on like chemistry. They don't even tell you what the tobacco is. I don't even know really where it's made, where it's from, tobacco. What I can tell you is that they do say there are a few different blends that they have. There's only a couple of them that they're going to keep making. I believe this is going to be one of them. The last time I had this cigar, it smoked pretty good. And it was pretty enjoyable. This one already starting out pretty decent. Really, really strong. Very, very strong cigar. It is, if I remember right, it is General Cigar owned company. And I was very surprised because when I tried it last week, when I did the review before, I tried the review, I did it, the whole thing, and then when I played it back, there was no sound. So I did a test, and it had sound, so it better have sound the whole way. I was surprised by it, because I didn't expect it any, I didn't know what to expect, and ended up being a very decent cigar. This one, like I said, very strong in flavor, very strong. It's like a Maduro wrapper. Pretty nice look here. This is my one of the areas I'll probably do a few cigar reviews here. This is the area that I live now, moved, and so I was gone for a couple weeks as far as doing a review. Finally got one out last week, and like I said, it didn't turn out, so that was really nice. But believe cigar was like $5.80, and I actually thought it was more. So it's priced very nicely. It's definitely worth taking a look at. If you can find it at your cigar store, I would go ahead and give it a try. you like a stronger cigar, definitely give it a try. It's definitely worth it. I don't know. I do wish that they would say a little bit more. They, at least as far as what they say, they don't want you to go in with any kind of ideas of what the cigar is supposed to taste like. So, I don't know. They could give you some information, maybe. Maybe they'll release the information as far as the blends and stuff like that. Maybe they already have and I haven't found it. But if I do find it, I'll post it, let you know. And so let's just kind of keep going. This is not my porch. That porch is gone. This is the really nice pool area. And there's it's very nice here. So I might show you around a little bit. At least this little pool area, depending on the situation when I'm done with this. And hope everybody's doing well. This is a pretty big cigar. Pretty big ring gauge. It's a 60 ring gauge, 5.5 length. So that's a pretty thick cigar. Probably last time it was just around, it was about an hour and 20 minutes, something like that I was smoking it, so. And it is a very bold cigar. Pretty strong. So if you're starting out and you see this cigar that looks like this, and then had this at the end of it here. See that right there. If you're starting out and you see that cigar, you might want to move on to something else and try a few others that are probably less bold. Now, if you do, you still may really enjoy it. I'm not gonna tell you not to smoke it, but just be warned, it is a strong cigar. And hello, I'm back. The it decided to stop on me. I ran out of room, so I had to delete some apps. I'm using my old phone for my camera, of course. And there we go. Anyway, it's burning decent, not too bad. It's definitely a strong cigar. Real extra black coffee. No sugar, no cream. Very, very robust cigar. Something you definitely want to keep in mind if you're looking for one. It's not a bad cigar. It's definitely worth the $6 or whatever, a little bit less that you pay, and especially if you like a stronger cigar. All kinds of different things have gone on in the last month or a few weeks, a couple weeks since I've done a review last, and just life goes on for everybody, and, well, at least while we're here, they do. Of course, we also will be losing people, losing our own lives at some point, so you just kind of got to live your life and enjoy it. And never know what happens, you know? You just have to really, really keep doing whatever you can to get the enrichment that you can out of life and stuff like that. So, I didn't bring anything with me to drink. So I'm kind of missing that right now, like either a coffee or water or something. Mouth is pretty dry. Still just a very strong tobacco taste going on. There are some decent flavors in there, but nothing, it's not like this complex cigar. It's just a very deep, almost like a, thick molasses, something like that. Burning a little bit funky, but not bad still. There's no wind. If there was a wind, I don't know how it would be holding up. The other one I smoked held up very well, held a very big ash, real tight. But the draw is very good. Consistent so far from the other one that I also smoked. So, like I said, it's definitely worth for what you pay, which is not a whole lot. I think the cigar is worth giving it a try. I don't know. Really, kind of awkward. There's nobody here. There's one person in the hot tub over this way, and that's really about it. But I don't, but there are, you know, it's like, seems like I shouldn't be real loud, but anyway, so I'm trying not to be like too loud, so I'm kind of just a little bit laid back, maybe a little bit more than usual, and hopefully it's not too boring today. Probably might be a little bit more boring than some of my other boring ones, but this one's a little bit on the upper echelon of more boring. I think if there's anything new other than my move, my different surroundings. Christmas is coming. Hanukkah has ended. Don't know the dates for Kwanzaa. Sorry. Easter is still coming. Not there yet. Valentine's Day. You can see there's a lot of smoke coming from this cigar. It's very huge. It's like a big fireplace right here. Pretty incredible. But the it's very strong. Very strong cigar. It would definitely help to have a little something with it. You definitely, like, if you don't smoke a lot of cigars, you'll want to probably have something in your stomach. Because it could, you could get pretty woozy from it, a little bit, bleh, you know? I know I probably would if I hadn't eaten just not too long ago. Saturday night, 9:30, and it is about 50 degrees maybe outside right now, which is beautiful. I have to say this, light thing, hoodie on. And I know in some places it is freaking freezing, so sorry. But that is why I'm here. I guess we could talk a little bit of football for a second. my team, the Denver Broncos, lost at home to the Chargers. And I kind of expected my team to win that game. And I don't expect them to win very often. That one I kind of did. And, you know, they're any given Thursday. they lost. They played like crap. They deserved to lose. If they would have won, it probably shouldn't have been. So, you know, San Diego played a very good game. And Rivers played a good game. I don't really like him very much. I do and I don't. There's that love-hate relationship with that guy. And, so football is getting interesting. There's a couple more games. Looks like, depending on what happens tomorrow, Patriots could go ahead and be the number one seed for the playoffs, but that didn't mean anything to the Broncos last year, so you never know. It's kind of fun to watch, I guess. No big surprises with the exception of what's going on in Washington with them going to go ahead and sit RG3 down for the rest of the season to protect him. I don't know if that's what they're really doing. It'll be interesting to see what happens. If Shanahan stays, if he gets fired, if he goes somewhere else, whatever happens, I don't know. But that's football. What else? Anything else? Not really. I don't, I believe Paul Walker was laid to rest today, which, you know, people dying every day, but he is a celebrity. He's actually younger than me. You know, kind of died in the prime of his career, his movie career. Pretty sad when somebody gets taken from a car accident, especially like that. And it's just, you never know. When our time clock is punched, it is, and that's just it. So, you never know. A meteor could fall out of the sky and land on top of me any minute. You never know. That's why you just gotta kind of live, so. I hope everybody's doing good, and sorry I haven't been doing a ton of reviews, but got life to live, and these just come when I can do one, so I hope everybody's getting a chance to smoke a good cigar, relax with some family, and hope the silly season of the Christmas and all that crap is not treating anybody too roughly, because I know it can be rough on some people. But anyway, that's about it, I think. I think I'm just going to go ahead and say hello. Feel free to pick this cigar up. I think you'll like it if you like a stronger cigar. Again, it's the Elements cigar, and this is the Carbon by the Foundry Tobacco Factory. Tobacco Factory, I believe. Tobacco company, something like that. It's hard to remember when they have very little information on their stuff, but I'll see if I can find some more. Not bad. So, take care of yourself. I hope everybody has a very good upcoming week, and don't let the holidays get into you too much. Just keep living life. Keep trying to love the people around you, and just have a great day. I'll be seeing you very soon. Bye-bye.